Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at the difference between slicers and the filter pane. And is there a difference? Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, slicers versus the filter pane. What's the difference? Both actually have the impact of filtering data in your report, right? So sometimes you want to see it for a certain year or you want to see it for a certain category. And both of those allow you to do that. As the saying goes, the devil's in the details. And that's what I want to get into a little bit here, just so you're better equipped to make the right decision in your reports. All right. Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my machine and see what this is all about. All right, so I've got a few visuals on the report canvas. One thing to note with regards to filtering data, just remember that each visual can filter each other. So if I say I want to look at accessories only, I can click on accessories and you'll see that it does impact other visuals around me. So that's one way of filtering your data. But there are other ways that people can interact with the data to get the answers that they want. So let's say that I wanted to look at this for a given year. So what I can do is I can take my year column, drag that over here, and I'm going to choose the slicer visual. That's right. The slicer is a visual. And it's important to remember that each visual on the canvas will issue one or more queries to the storage engine. Now, if you're doing everything in import, usually this is okay. Usually, but if you're doing direct query, this could have drastic effect on the amount of queries going back to your data source. So just be mindful of that from a slicer perspective, it is a visual. So by default, it's going to be the slider option, and you can look at that, right? We can slide it. We can do different things from a year perspective. One thing that I see a lot of people doing is just choosing a list visual. So here we can just select the year that we want to slice on, and that's cool. Just a pro tip from a performance perspective, one thing I would recommend is defaulting to a drop-down slicer. The thing about drop-down slicers is that when you're actually using this, when you go to load that report page, it's actually not gonna send a query for the slicer if it's a drop-down. So it won't actually send the query until you select the drop-down to go get the list of items. So it's almost like you're deferring the query at that point, which is just a good practice, and it can help reduce the load of the report itself. So you can see here, when I go to actually choose the dropdown, like actually select it to get me the list, that's when the actual query would be run for that given slicer. Another interesting thing from a slicer perspective that filters don't necessarily have is, you know, each visual, we can actually control the interactions of other visuals. If I go to format, edit interactions, I could say, look, I only want this to filter the total sales amount. So now let's turn that off. And now when we do years, we'll see that it is not affecting the other visuals. It is only affecting the total sales amount, right? So we could be selective in how we actually use slicers to do that. There's another aspect to slicers as well called sync slicers, but I want to come back to that once we look at the filters, because that's going to come into play from the filter pane perspective. So let's take a look at the filter pane. All right, so the filter pane itself, it's over here. You can expand and collapse it, and you can add things to this. So one thing we can see is we can see filters on this page, and then we can see filters on all pages. I can even go a step further, and if I select a visual, then we'll actually see filters on the visual. So I've got the visual itself, I've got the entire page, which is this entire canvas, and then I have all pages. So that's pretty cool. So if I do year, I could say I want year on this whole page. I could change that to basic filtering, and I can have that same effect that the slicer has. So it's the same exact type of filtering that I can do there. One thing you'll note is that from the filter pane perspective, I don't have that edit interaction. So I can't necessarily say this is only for this visual or this visual. That's where the filters on this visual section come into play. It's a little bit more manual work because you actually have to go and set all that up. Filters also have this advanced filtering option, which allows you to do some OR conditions and some more complex filtering conditions than what a slicer necessarily allows you to do. So be aware of that. From a performance perspective, another thing I recommend when you go to save the report, have the filter pane collapse, not expanded. So I talked about with the slicers, the drop-down box, that can allow you to defer the queries. The same thing is true if the filter pane is collapsed. So if that filter pane is collapsed, then it's not gonna go issue the queries for the filter drop-down items that are a part of it. So that's another way you can defer performance. All right, I said I would come back to sync slicers. So think about this section, the filters on all pages. Now, the thing with filter on all pages is that filter is going to be applied to the entire report. Slicers by default don't allow you to do that, but sync slicers potentially can allow you to do that. So from a sync slicer perspective, what I can do is go to view, and then I can actually choose sync slicers. Now, what this allows me to do is I can say page one, that's where I'm seeing it. And then I can say this slicer is available on other pages. And you'll see that it's there because I have another slicer with the year dropdown. And so that's why it's showing up on others. But you can say that it's also affecting, it's syncing between these pages. So my year slicer on my page one is not syncing with the other year slicers on the other pages. So if I wanted to control additional overview as well as my overview slicer panel page, I could say, yep, I want this to be synced as well. So now anytime I make a change here, it's going to change those other pages. So this is a way you can get that filter on all pages. The other beautiful thing about this is you'll also see that on this additional overview page, I'm not showing the slicer. It's affecting the page, but it's not actually visible on that page. So that's another way that you can get some cool interactions with your reports and using slicers instead of filters. Or you could have a similar effect on the filters on all pages. So the difference here is that while filter pane does have filter on all pages, it doesn't allow you to do selective filtering on pages. Whereas sync slicers does give you that benefit, but there's a little bit more management that you have to do with it in order to get it set up. So there's some give and takes on both sides. All right, so that's the basics of slicers and filters. One thing I wanna do just to get your ideas revving here, you could go a step further and have what I refer to as a slicer panel. And so this is a way that you can actually use the combination of bookmarks, selections, and buttons to actually get more app-like experiences. So one thing you'll see here is if I click on my little hamburger icon, I have a bookmark set up where it will actually go through and do these things. You also notice 2016 was highlighted. That was because of my sync slicer. And so if I uncheck that, now all years are present and I can close the slicer panel and now I can interact with these. The benefits of a slicer panel is that it actually allows you to defer the loading of those visuals as well. So you'll notice I had a list slicer that's there and I said dropdown allows you to defer it. But if the visual's not visible, then it's going to defer that as well. So having the slicer panel hidden by default, that means that those visuals aren't going to actually execute on page load. So that has the same kind of benefit as the dropdown slicer. And I've got a link in the description below to a video I did a while back on creating a slicer panel. So go check that out if you're interested in how I did it. One more thing I want to talk to you about with regards to direct query. And this is the concept of query reduction. So when you go into options of your report, come down to query reduction. And this allows you to change some things by default. So I mentioned that you can do edit interactions for the slicers. The first option there is that you can disable cross highlighting and filtering by default. So it reverses the paradigm. So nothing interacts with each other. And then you can selectively turn that on. But slicers and filters both have an additional item here. So for slicers, I could say add an apply button to each slicer to apply those changes. So by default, when I change a slicer selection, it's automatically going to execute queries on the relevant visuals. If you want to do like a multi-select, you can make those changes and then hit apply to then execute the query. So that way you're not adding all these additional queries to the storage engine, especially if it's direct query. So for example, let me go ahead and hit okay. And if we go and expand this now, one thing you'll see here is I can do multiple years and then hit apply and then it will go to the given item. So it's not gonna actually execute those items until I hit apply. Now, a drawback here, if we go back to our query reduction settings, the difference the filter pane actually has that you can have a single apply button to the entire filter pane, whereas the slicers, it's going to be on each individual slicer. So that's an option that you've got to think about in terms of how you want to work with that report, especially if you're doing direct query and how you want to manage that for the actual user interaction. There may be some education required for your users to understand what's available in that report if you're going down that road. All right, that was just a quick look at slicers versus filters. Hopefully you learned something new. If you did, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, for both Patrick and myself, thanks for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.